heart she came, only to fly away, only to fly as day flies from moonlight. Now I'm alone. Of things I wish were true, I keep remembering evenings I wish I spent with you. I keep remembering kisses from lips I've never owned, and all the lovely adventures that in paradise, this promise of paradise, this nearly was mine. Close to my heart she came, still dreaming of paradise, still saying that paradise once nearly was
Beck. Take off pretty soon for Marie Louise. Good hunting up there. Jap carriers, cargo boats, big game. You know what side of the island I should land on? will land on the south side. There is a cove there, and rocks.
We will land.
Then we will get in touch with some of my friends, Tonkinese. They will hide us in the hills.
You mean you're coming with me?
Of course. You are too young to be out alone. And now, I haven't got so much to lose.
You wanted to see me, Captain?
Billis, you've broken every regulation in the book, and by God, I'm gonna throw it at you.
Sir, if I might explain myself. I happened to overhear Lieutenant Cable and Mr. DeBeck discussing a certain operation. Liking projects myself, I happened to stow away on the plane.
Yes, and you happened to fall out of the plane and land in a rubber boat in the middle of Empress Augusta Bay and float there all day while the entire Navy Air Force tried to rescue you.
Sir, actually, the pilot says that this fella Billis caused a kind of inadvertent diversionary action.
Totally inadvertent.
While all those Japs were busy shooting at our planes and Billis, that sub was depositing the Frenchman and Joe Cable.
Well, what the hell do you want me to do? Give him a bronze star?
I don't want a bronze star, Captain. But I could use a little freedom. A little room to swing around it, if you know what I mean.
Get the hell out of here!
Yes, sir.
Captain Brackett, Cable and DeBeck are calling in.
So we are on, Marie-Louise. We have made contact with former friends of mine. The weather here, clouds over Bougainville, the Treasuries, Trussell, and New Georgia. We expect rain from 900 to 1400.
All you Navy, Marine, and Army pilots, write this down. Surface craft, 19 troop barges headed down the bottleneck. Speed about 11 knots. Ought to pass Benica at about 2000 tonight. Escorted by heavy warships.
Send out our pilots, Bill. We'll knock those guys out of the war.
Captain, it's been 2 weeks, and Miss Forbush is here. You'll have to tell her sometime.
All right, send her in.
Captain Brackett, I know this isn't regular. It's about Emil DeBeck. I went to his house and he wasn't there. I even asked his children and they didn't seem to know where he'd gone. At least I think that's what they said. They only speak French. And then tonight in the ward, a lot of fighter pilots kept talking about a Frenchman and a convoy that got knocked out. And I was wondering if this Frenchman could be my Frenchman.
Yes, Miss Forbush, it is. I couldn't tell you before, but, well, as a matter of fact, if you wait here a few minutes, you can hear his voice.
His voice? Where is he?
With Lieutenant Cable behind enemy lines.
He's calling in, Captain.
Hello, my friends and allies. My message today must be brief and sad. Lieutenant Cable died last night from wounds he received 3 days ago. I will never know a finer man. I wish he could have told you the good news. The Japanese are pulling out, and there is great confusion. You may not hear from me for several days. 2 planes are overhead, looking for us, we think. We believe that...
Believe what? What's he believe?
Well, that's all, Miss Forbush. He was cut off.
Poor Joe. Poor Joe Cable. Captain Brackett. Do you think there's a chance I'll ever see Emil DeBeck again?
There's a chance. There's always a chance.
I didn't know he was going.
Well, of course not. How could he tell you he was going? Now, don't blame Emil DeBeck. He's okay. He's a wonderful guy.
He sure is.